Hello, greetings, my friends. This is Gilles Mancillon. I come back to you much more in a more comfortable situation. I want to talk about a few things. The first thing is that we've passed through the big event that was called the confinement, this COVID-19. It's one of five storms that have been organized to awaken humanity, and we're going to come into the second storm really soon. It will be triggered by announcement, probably before the American election. And so the planet may be on lockdown again. There may be a phase two. We don't know yet, but there is going to be a phase two that will be coming very soon. And then phase three, phase four, phase five. But for us, as we went through the dark night of the soul ahead of time, we'll be prepared for all those things that are coming, when a lot of people will not have been going through that, and they will have no choice but to go through that. For the separation between the fear base and the love base, we're going to be more intensified. Those who are into power and control, and those who are into love and unity and inclusion, will be... the difference is going to manifest, it's going to become more visible, the black and white nature of things. For all the old needs to be expurged. But very slowly but surely, we're going to be able to see that there will be great surprises from heaven, where there is no way we can know the future. The future is very uncertain right now for most people, for we have guidelines from our inner self. But... for the decision, originally we came as most light workers, as 6 million light workers that came to anchor the golden age, the preparation for the new age to come. And the decision was to have a very short life, to come in, to anchor the light and to leave. But then as we got here, we decided, most collectively, individually, but... most people decided to have a long life and to see the beginning of that peace, of that golden age, to see it all the way through the process, no matter how painful that may be. And so we will see the beginning of the golden age, the age of peace and prosperity and harmony and concord. And although it will take some work to get there, I'm going to speak about some amazing experience I just had. But I'm going to pull a few cards first. We'll see what the angels may want to tell us today. For the angels are always everything is been divinely orchestrated. For me, I will soon leave Caen. I know there's some amazing happenings, things that are happening with the words I've been through. For those who have followed my video, I've been through hell. It's been hell. It's like never again going through something like that. Even somebody came, one of my soul brother from above, I think it was a spirit, came down and said, "How could you handle all that?" And it's like they gave me so much, I couldn't, even more than I could handle, but I made it through, right? So the situation is leaving. It is leaving. It's confirming what I'm saying. We're all going to be shifting. Some people may need to stay in the area they're in, but a lot of people, a lot of light workers are going to be moving to other places, more into the mission, the function. What comes around the situation is justice. For the divine justice may not have been visible in the past, but because the darkness was ruling here. But very soon it's gonna clear up a lot of things. Some things will come up. The people will have no. They will have no choice but to recognize all this darkness that is coming from within them, and so we all need to assist them if we can. What we see before us is doubt, doubt is a dead center. There is really, we don't know, there is so much uncertainties, and yet we have to stay very positive and receptive to we ask, and then we move into the state of receptivity. We align with the energy, we let go of the desire, we let go of the asking, but we make a very precise asking at the first, and then we surrender it to the universe, and then we move into a relaxed state, in a receptive state, where we align to the energies that we've been asking for. So once the doubts will lead us to knowledge, it will be knowledge that will be imparted. For now, we're still working through the process. For in the past and distant past, it's been indulgence. We've been a bit indulgent. We didn't want to let go of many of those things in our comfort zone, but we've learned that we can do without those things, and there is a greater sense of appreciation. Right now, we're moving into clairvoyance. There is a deep state of clairvoyance that is the third eye is opening. There is so much that has been revealed through dreams and insight. what is coming up in the near future is clear audience. It is about listening to all that life is telling you. Very important for the not necessarily on the surface, but there is a message between the great mirror of life and your inner self, and so just be in the contemplative state where you can actually receive the information wherever you are, for life is everywhere. Our strength within the situation is well-being. We have a new sense of well-being. We have to relax to be able to find this inner peace and to find this well-being, for the quality of life will soon become very, very important. For me, I'm very eager to return to wearing a suit and tie and going back to work. It's been an initiation of sort, but I'm really happy to be come out of it. I need to come out of it expecting some, which come to from the outside world, liberation. Exactly. So the card has like preceded me in that process of saying it. For the liberation will be coming. We'll be liberated in one way. It's whenever we're ready. For life is always ready, and it is. But on the collective level, there will be some step by step process to awaken humanity. What we find in our hopes and fears is equilibrium. So it's a balanced energy. It's to recognize we can never be perfect. Only God is perfect, and God has kept the role of the referee. He leads, it guides, it refers, it balances out. It's like the role is chosen, and then we chose to come down here and to move from the impure to the pure, from the darkness into light, from ignorance into lucidity. And so, but we need to keep things in balance and not to be extremes not to go into any extremes, and to release things really quickly, and to go to the heart and release it, or release all the energies of the chakras, and that will come to the outcome will be acceptation. To be a full acceptation of who we are, where we are, what we are, and all the great gift that will be blessing our life really soon. So we want to move into this state of well-being and acceptance. So I hope this message was interesting for you. So let's share an experience that just happened to me. There's many experiences, for I'm very spiritually connected, so I receive experiences every day. But this one I thought I'd share because I was outside, and it was night, and it was cold. Well, it wasn't that cold, but it was raining. And so I pulled myself in the door of a church, a beautiful Roman church, very old church. And I was sitting there for like a few hours. And all of a sudden there was the word Lourdes came into my mind. Lourdes is a place in France where there is many miracles have been made in this place. People come from all around the world to healness and so on. And I made connection with Notre Dame de Lourdes, and there was this beautiful light just came and looked at me, and I looked, and we exchanged message, communication, and she saw that I was sincere in the service of God. And then Saint Anne came down, another lady came down, and then a third lady came into my body and made a gift to me in terms of energetics. And I'm still in contact with those ladies. They dress like nuns, like Catholic nuns. They're like saints. And it's a beautiful energy. It's like a portal, this place, Lourdes. I may have to go one day in physicality to thank them, not to get, but I asked them for miracle. They're experts in miracle, and I need miracles in my life. So I thought, I shared this little story with you. I'm going to sing a song. It's another great song by Robert Allen Zimmerman. It goes like this. How many roads must a man walk down before you can call him a man? Yes, how many seas must a white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? Yes, how many times must the cannonball fly before they're forever banned? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Yes, how many years can a mountain exist before it is washed to the sea? Yes, how many years can some people exist before they're allowed to be free? Yes, how many times can a man turn his head and pretend that he just doesn't see? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Yes, how many times must a man look up before he can see the sky? Yes, how many ears must a man have before he can hear people cry? Yes, how many deaths will he take till he knows that too many people have died? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Well, I'm ready to open the champagne really soon. Huh? I see, I feel it, I sense it. I know it's gonna be so major for me. It's gonna be a life shifting energy that is about to come into my life. I do feel it, I sense it, I know it. And so it is. It is. So the highest wisdom for us today is co-creation. We are asked to co-create with the universe, for God is the creator, but we have to lend a hand to the co-creation of our life. And so it for God will take cue from us until we take a cue from God, and then we'll follow whatever vision God has for us, which is far better than what we can think. And what we need to understand is a step ahead, is to be a step ahead, to have this insight, to find the right connection, to believe in synchronicity, to be ready for what is to come, for we've been prepared for what is to come. What we need to do is going in circle. It means it feels like we don't have it, the door is not open, we're going in circle. So it's okay, it's about being patient. Spirit was telling me that I will be happy that I waited here on this planet, that I didn't like transmuted my energy, that I didn't release my physical body, because what is to come will be really, really happening, really happy. And so it is, and the outcome will be breathing to learn to, because we're going to be able to find all that we need within the breath. Once the breath is free, once we let go of the shallow breath and move into the deep breath, the infinity breath, it's like if envisioning a number 8 that crosses at around the navel. And you make 8 breathing, and then you can envision it in your navel, one into all the chakras when it is open and back. And this number 8 will be very powerful. This infinity breathing, you hold, you release. There's many breathing techniques, but we're going to be learning them, for eventually we'll find all that we need from within the sacred breath, and that's sheltered by the lung and sponsored by the heart. And so it is relearning those basic things, for we thought we were out in the clear, we thought we were ready for ascension in 2012, but there were more things to deal with, and that we didn't see. It's like an onion, so we have to peel and peel and peel, but we'll be happy from the result. No matter what we need to go through in this difficult time, we'll be happy with the result. That's what my soul and spirit is telling me. And so let us stay together in optimism and be ready for magic and miracle to come into your life. Thank you very much. Namaste.